My biggest fear when I was little was to be alone, because I was left alone a lot when I was a baby.
Take the freaking rattle. There you go. Now, I'll talk to you later. I'm busy right now. Mommy's doing work!
The only time that I wouldn't be alone is when my uncle comes to my house to take me out. But that'll only be like once a week. How's my dog doing?
I do good.
That's good, that's good. You wanna go somewhere really nice?
I wanna go somewhere really nice.
You think you deserve it?
Yeah, good boy.
Let's go to the zoo then.
The zoo!
Let's go.
Let's go to the zoo!
We're gonna get some pizza, don't worry. Stop riding around. Seriously. You wanna go? Let's go. Come on, let's go get some pizza. But then there was a period of time that my uncle didn't come to my house for months. Every time the doorbell rang, I thought it was him, but it wasn't.
Shut up, please! It's just the pizza guy, all right? Me and my friends are in there, and we're trying to have some fun, so I would appreciate it if you would just, you know, shut up and, like, watch, like, your Nickelodeon or whatever.
Finally, I realized I needed to get out of my life and just get used to being alone. My story, I definitely wanted to make it funny because I hate sad stories. I hate when people cry now over movies and stuff, so I wanted to make it funny at the same time as you get in that drama in my life.
She kept calling. That's what I remember the most, is that she kept calling. It was like a dream, a scene from a movie. But I thought this was the kind of thing parents were supposed to hide from their kids. The hallway seemed to go on forever. It was dark. The only light was at the end. And that's where the phone was. I was around 12.
Where'd you find the courage to pick up the phone?
It wasn't really about courage. It was about me being fed up.
How did that situation affect you?
At the time, I think it pushed me over an edge where I had no sympathy for my dad anymore.
I like to put a lighter side on it. Just because it was sad doesn't mean you can't put something around it to make people more comfortable with it. It could teach a lesson, but also really, really entertain, like that cat story.
I was bored out of my mind at my sister's birthday party, and my sister had gotten a cat. He hated me from the beginning. I knew this cat was evil. He terrorized me by day and haunted my dreams by night. One night I woke up with him staring at me. horror. The horror.
When I was like 4 years old, that was scary. But then I realized that it was stupid. Mm. If it's stupid, it can be funny.
Like when you have like something that's really private to you, like, and then you add humor, it's easier to tell, like...
You know all that teen angst that everybody supposedly has? Yeah. If you have it, if it actually does exist, you can... It's it's an outlet. You write and perform and...
That's my future. That's what I want. No matter how many people say, oh, there's no money in theater or there's no money in this, it doesn't matter. It's what I want to do.
I come here after having a hard day every day. Like, you know, I get to be me. I get to have fun with my friends and not have to deal with all the trouble and... life.
How many people can say that they're happy at their job?
That's true. Yeah. Not many
people. I think the world would be such a better place if we were all doing something that we love.
Afraid to see next time that they try to treat you like you're a freak, cause you're straight and look good.